I don't know if you've heard about this, but Microsoft issuing an emergency software update after damage caused by Intel Spectra and Meltdown patches.
Yeah, joining us now is tech expert Shelly Palmer. Good morning to you, Shelly.
Good morning.
So what's this all about?
So everybody really gets bored with Microsoft sending you notices to do a security patch and update your software. Remember, Spectre and Meltdown, these two security flaws that are at the processor level, actually at the chip level in your Intel chips when you're Intel inside, are real. So if Microsoft is sending you a notice saying, hey, we've got a software patch, do yourself a favor, please do it, because the vulnerability is real. Everybody's becoming so apathetic to this. Do your security patches. That's today's big message.
Okay, so what's up with the Spectre CPU patch? What do we need to know about that, and how does it make us vulnerable?
At the moment, how it makes you vulnerable, I could do a TV special on.
Okay.
So let's not go there. What I will tell you is that Microsoft is sending out patches. You'll get a software notification that says, update your software. Do yourself a favor. Update your software.
Okay.
It's free, and just do it, and don't be apathetic to this, and don't go with somebody else's problem. These are real, so fix them.
All right, so let's move on to Twitter, because New York's chief prosecutor is saying the state is opening an investigation into a firm that, you know, apparently sold millions of fake followers, Twitter followers, to social media users. Are these bots? You know,
well, it's kind of rampant now.
Yeah.
People have always bought followers. Celebrities get judged by how many people follow them, so they buy followers. And that's pretty harmless, unless, of course, they're getting paid for having millions of followers. But people are also buying retweets now. And those retweets are coming from what look like credible accounts, because these bots are impersonating people by identity theft.
So they're duplicates, or are they the actual accounts?
No, they're duplicates. What someone will do is they'll take your picture, they'll take your history, they'll create a new Twitter account or a fake Facebook account, and then activate this bot. And this bot can be, you know, people always think about bot farms as somewhere offshore where there's someone, you know, typing. No, this is all done by computer. And they just go steal a bunch of pictures, and they steal a bunch of identities, and then they start to retweet. So buying a retweet is crazy, because it makes you think whoever is got the Twitter account is actually more powerful than they are, because when they send out a tweet to activate someone, come down and buy my book, and everybody retweets, come down and buy my book, wow, they have all these Twitter followers, and look at all those retweets. Of course, it's all false.
But have verified on Twitter, I mean, does that protect you in any way?
No. Okay.
This is scary.
Yeah.
It's been around a long time, but Eric Schneider is very depressed right now, because people are actually suffering from what they believe is identity theft. You find your picture as a bot, or your history, or your information as a bot, as a duplicate account.
So what can you do to protect yourself? Because I don't think anybody wants bots to be following them, or nobody wants that.
I don't want to push a particular service. There are plenty of services on Google that you just Google and Twitter bot verification or Twitter verification. There are plenty of services that will verify to your Twitter account. And when you see something that's just an egg or a picture, it's got one follower or two followers, it's on 20 tweets, you know it's just delete it. Just delete it if
and
it's following you.
And half of their user handle is like numbers.
Delete it. There are services that will help you wholesale do that, you can pay for. This is a big problem, because we are so sort of addicted to social media now. Everybody's like, oh, this one's got a million followers. Like, well, maybe they do, and maybe they don't. And so, and then if they're retweeting, you think they're real, but of course, that doesn't mean they are.
Nothing is real anymore.
Nope. Not, can't even
Black
trust Twitter. Oh, no.
I thought if you were verified, that meant something, but obviously
if you are verified, it does mean something, but if the bots don't have to be.
You're right, sir. Thank you so much, Shelly Palmer.